Welcome along, everyone, to sunny Spain, specifically to the Circuit de Barcelona-Catalunya. So many great moments in Formula One history have been written at this very track over the years, including Michael Schumacher's first win for Ferrari back in 96. That win was in the rain. We might have better weather here today, but we're just as overjoyed to be at the Spanish Grand Prix. It's an updated track at Catalunya, and the popular opinion in the paddock is that we never wanted the chicane in the first place. That's now been gone, the final corner is much faster, and at 2.9 miles and 14 turns, we await the Spanish Grand Prix. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole. Sergio Perez lines up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Russell, Norris, Hamilton, Gasly, Sainz, Oscar Piastri, Fernando Alonso, Tsunoda, Joe, Sargent, Bottas, Magnussen, Ocon, Hülkenberg, Jackson, De Vries, Stroll, Albon, and Noah Bell. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. Welcome to the wonderful Catalunya. It's time for the Spanish Grand Prix this weekend. And whilst the season is just a few races old, it's already been one full of drama. So, Natalie Pinkham, who have you got your eye on this weekend?
Well, in Formula One, naturally, the conversation is drawn towards those at the top of the standings, both drivers and teams. But I'm really intrigued by the midfield team of Connor Sport. Devon Butler's absence will definitely be felt. There's no doubt about that, both on and off the track. For me, the interesting thing will be how they move forward without him.
Indeed, almost as many battles off the track as there are on it for Connor Sport at the moment. And Casper Ackermann and his team certainly have their work cut out for them this weekend.
I know it's been a mad few weeks, mate, but you've always gone well here. So let's get your head down and see what we can do. Come on. Nice move. Good job. We can now use CRS. CRS now available. Right, you're coming up to one of the Aston Martins now. approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 10.8 seconds. Good job, nice overtake. Okay, we want you to pit this lap, so push now, push. Okay, let's go now. Come on. Perfect job from you and the crew there, mate. We're delighted with that. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Noah's in the pits. Noah is in the pits now. Brilliant, nice move, keep going. Gap to your teammate behind is 25.1 seconds. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. right, we've got enough fuel for three more laps. Okay, the car behind is dropping back. We're seeing a gap starting to form. And that's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
So it's Aidan Jackson propping up Konnersport here today, but the big news off the track is the speculation about this team, whether or not they'll see out the season with their current lineup.
Well, I think they'll have to sign a new driver, Crofty. It's a gamble worth taking.
Well, a mid-season signing would get us all talking, I'm sure, but time will tell. The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everybody at the team.
Well, Konnersport are in a bit of an odd situation right now. So, just tell me, what is it like for you today?
Yeah, not so long ago, my teammate was Devon, and we had a plan sorted out for the rest of the season. Now it's Noah, and for the last couple of races, suddenly nobody's quite sure what the situation is. I've never had to drive in this situation before, so it's all pretty strange, but you do what you can.
Most importantly, how is Devon? And how are you finding it without your teammate?
I honestly never thought I'd say this, but I do miss him. He brought a lot of energy to the team, and it feels odd not to have him around right now. For the record, I'm not saying I like him. He'd never let me hear the end of it. But he's missed at Konnersport, that's for sure.
Well, there's a lot of talk about what happens if Devon doesn't return. Would Konnersport be looking for a new driver, do you think?
That sounds like a question for Casper. I know they need to plan for every situation. That's just the nature of the sport, but you know, if those discussions are happening, I'm definitely not involved with that.
Well, thank you for chatting with us. Great to have your time.
Hey, Casper, you wanted to speak to me?
Yes, I did.
Shoot.
Nothing major, really. To be honest, I just wanted to thank you.
Oh. What for? I'm, you know, just doing my job.
No, it's more than that. Well, I know why you stayed on the team. And, well, I won't lie to you, it's not been easy.
Yeah, you can say that again.
Yeah, but you really stepped up. It's good for me to know that I've got someone like you to rely on.
Always.
Yeah. Look, Aiden, I'll warn you, things may not get any easier, at least not for a while, but, well, we've got something in the pipeline, a potential new driver, and a damn good one.
Who is it?
I can't say, not yet. It's a bit of a gamble, but if they agree, we could have something special.
Nice. And, how is Devon?
Fine. I think... I'm not sure. I mean, Davidov has closed the door on that one, but... Yeah, he tells me Devon is in a good place, though.
Oh, that's good, that's good.
Just, you know, keep doing what you're doing, okay? And now, just get out of here.
Of course. I'll catch you later, Casper.